Sometimes your heart's too full to even do a happy dance. You have to just say, well done, Mother Nature. Yeah. Well done.
Get ready to pull in. There's deer over there in our neighborhood.
What is it, Maggie? Is it an armadillo? It is.
He has tried really hard to fix it.
And along with the chair biting the dust, when it breaks, whoever's sitting in it bites the dust too, so. You know, none of us could cook, but we could put a hamburger and some veggies and different things, aluminum foil, and then put it next to the fire, and that was dinner. Well done, Mother Nature. Mm-hmm. Well done.
Get ready to pull in. There's deer over there in our neighbor's campsite. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to have any problem getting in here. Hey, pretty girl. You are a good pup. Did you see the deer over there? Did you? Do you see him, Meg? Hey. You're so precious. What is that baby?
She's cute. What do you think? Yeah, we're going to have to let our pup dog out. She's about to go crazy.
Don't chase him, Maggie, okay?
What is it, Maggie? Is it an armadillo? Kind of got you by the woohoo, Brick Maggie. You need to be careful. Okay, so we've stayed at a few places that have a little wildlife around. And there's a lot in this place. There's just a lot to see, and it's driving Maggie crazy. You look like Pig Ben. Look at you. You're such a dog. You love it, don't you? You looking for the armadillo again? Look at all that stuff going off of you. Man alive, Maggie.
What are we going to do with you?
I cannot stand it.
I'm going to give you a bath. Good gracious. Yep. Such a freaking dog. You're such a dog.
This sight is driving Maggie crazy. I know, buddy. Is this your favorite campground? This is? I can remember, well, my friends and I going camping, my guys, you know, none of us could cook, but we could put a hamburger and some veggies and different things, aluminum foil, and then put it next to the fire, and that was dinner. Believe it or not, I've always loved that. Lynn has too, and that's what's for dinner tonight. It's way too hot to put our food on. I'm going to have to move some things around.
Got a layer of onions, then some hamburger that we had left over from making the hamburgers. It's got potatoes, carrots, and yellow and red peppers. I think it'll be good. I'm not going to put A1 on it either.
Our little setup over there for the hammock. It's just awesome.
It's cute, isn't it?
It's really cool, honey. It's comfortable, too. We had subscribers, Brian and Kathy, come around and see us, and Lynn was inside cutting all this up and putting it together. I actually had fallen asleep in the hammock back there. It was just so peaceful and quiet, and we really enjoyed meeting them. Maggie's another belly scratcher. This is Brian and Kathy and Rosie, right?
Yes, sir.
Hey, Rosie.
Oh,
hey, sweetheart. Hey, sweetheart.
Get her little papoose.
It is cool. Wow. Great. So was it a surprise or did she tell you?
She told me.
You couldn't?
I was so excited.
I was so excited.
He was like, no way, get out.
Yeah. That's cool, guys.
Such an inspiration to us.
Thank you, sweetheart. Yeah. Thank you.
Seeing y'all's minis, we ended up looking into red.
Good.
She rides in there.
She does, yeah.
You know, we've met so many on this trip so far. It's been one of the biggest surprises and one of the best parts of this trip so far, meeting all the folks that have come around to say thanks for doing what we do. We tell you all the time, we'd probably stop it, but we're not for you guys, but you guys just keep encouraging us to keep doing what we're doing and being part of the trekking family. We love it.
And we really, really appreciate it too. Thank you. The moment of truth.
They're done.
They good? Didn't burn it?
No.
Awesome.
We didn't, honey. We didn't. Potatoes. Man, this is hot, too.
It looks hot.
All right. Let's get yours off.
Okay. Let's do it. By the fire?
Yeah, we can. You want to do that?
Yeah. So...
Good morning, Lake Kissimmee. Never know if you're supposed to say Lake Kissimmee or Lake Kissimmee. I guess if you like getting a little sugar, you say Kissimmee. We're out here already. Maggie is already looking for the armadillos and the deer she saw last night. This is it. This is why you come to Florida. Well, and the beaches. It's just awesome, guys. Just awesome.
I'm gonna walk down to the store.
Yeah, let's see. They have a great trail from the loop we're in at the campground to go down to the marina and the store. Pretty cool, huh?
Path back to the campground.
It's nothing quite like waking up at a campground for the first morning, getting to go out and explore. And it's one of the reasons you know that we love state parks. And of all the state parks we've ever stayed in, I think it's probably easy to say Florida State Parks. They're right up there at the top. Might have something to do with the fact that I'm in short sleeves and it's already 75 degrees and it's only about 9:30 in the morning, but still, we love it. Now Lynn and I are gonna go back down this little cut, see how far into Lake Kissimmee we can go in our Oru kayaks. Glad you're with me.
Wow, just... wow. catch a little fish, fly across the water.
This bird's been following Owen all the way.
Now let's go check on a little magpie. Hey, baby.
Oh, baby.
Hey, baby.
Hey, my mommy.
We miss you. Looks like it.
This is life.
What do you see out there? Do you see an armadillo?
Like my pocketbook, I've got everything in here. I want to tell you that if you're coming from your site and you're coming over here to the trash cans and go to the other loop, there is no shortcut. It's not a shortcut to go through the middle of that loop to the bathroom and then back out. It just puts you right in the same place. Ends you up. That's a good word, isn't it? Ends you up right back where we started. Anyway, we're on our way over here to eat dinner.
Thank you.
It smells good.
I know, and I thought, he can't be with us if we had the no, because I got two, then I have to hold on to.
I need to put a piece of cheese on.
And then you need to, you like those, right?
Yeah, I love them. Mm-hmm.
They give her gas, but it's a bigger RV now. Well, as everyone around us has been tearing down and preparing to leave their site for the last hour or so, we also need to leave our site to move to a different site for one more night here at Lake Kissimmee State Park. But we're walking and taking our time. It's now about 10:45, and we have a little over 2 hours before we need to vacate the site. So what are we doing? They have really good washers and dryers here. No one uses the washers and dryers right when you're supposed to be checking out. So we found it's a really good time to stuff what you need to wash in the washer, go for a walk, come back, stuff it in the dryer, start packing up, multitask. Let me show you these washers and dryers here though. They're, for a state park, this is pretty awesome. Really new commercial washer and dryer. There's only one of each, but pretty cool. Washer's 25 minutes and $1.25, which is really cheap. The dryer is 45 minutes and only $1.25 as well.
It's a nice washing area. You've got folding tables on both sides, and it's relatively cheap compared to what we've seen in the past.
Let's walk over and see where you say goodbye to Jim and Sandy, okay?
You're right here beside us.
This is pretty cool, isn't it? We love state parks. This is one reason why. Just looking at this site, we have water and electricity, we have a place to dump, we have trash, we have the security of it being locked and having a gate code, we have over 20 miles of hiking that's here, we have the lake, we have biking. What else do you, brand new washers and dryers to be able to do your clothes, you know? All for like $28 a night in Florida. Short sleeves, January. We love it.
What do you think, pup dog? Happy? Why don't you lie down in your bed instead of laying right there on the dirt?
Starting our fourth week on this 3 month trip, or at least 3 months, we really don't know. But we haven't washed the van since we left all the snow and everything, and it was time. We had enough water here to be able to rinse the van off and wash it and clean all the windows and really clean inside. And well, it's just gonna feel really good for about 15 minutes. And then, well, then all the sand's going to get in there again. And then the only time it's rained in the last 10 days,
tomorrow. Isn't that the way it goes? I think farmers should hire me to come to their town when they need it to rain. I'll just wash my RV and it'll start raining. But it feels good right now. Oh, I see. There's another armadillo. Drives you crazy, doesn't it? It does. Get you all red faced, doesn't it? Yeah, I know. You just want to chase it, don't you? You don't need to, though. Leave it alone, okay? Same as yesterday, and the day before, and the day before. I know. Do you want me to look and see what it's doing? You do? Okay. Where is it? Right there. I don't see it. Oh, it went back through there, sweetie.
It's gone.
Yeah, you chased it off again.
Good Maggie.
You got it.
Good magpie poaching.
You need more allowance, don't you? You're just having to chase too many armadillos off of our little campsite. Doing things are driving Maggie crazy.
It was bound to happen. We've had these, I guess, about 5 years now. One of them has bit the dust.
He has tried really hard to fix it.
And along with the chair biting the dust, when it breaks, whoever's sitting in it bites the dust too. So tomorrow on the way through Tampa, we're going to stop and get another chair. So tonight, bye-bye. It's kind of sad.
It is. I love my Pico chair.
We've really liked this park, but Maggie has loved it. We're out for an evening stroll around the park and going down to the water and just hopefully catching a little bit of a sunset. And then we'll turn in for the night. But it has been an awesome stay. And I got to tell you, we came here because we were having a hard time finding something on a Friday night here. And we drove a little out of the way to get here. But boy, we're glad we did. This is one of our favorite stops, and it was just one that we thought was just going to fill us in until we could get down to Collier Seminole. So you never know, right? We've had really good neighbors, we've had really good weather, and because of that, we've had a really good time. Just beautiful. Don't have anything else to say about it other than my heart is full.
It's like when you don't expect a lot, it's when you get the most.
Sometimes your heart's too full to even do a happy dance. You have to just say, well done, Mother Nature. Yeah. Well done. So now, based upon how we love to camp, here's how we would rate Lake Kissimmee State Park. The campground at Lake Kissimmee State Park has 60 sites with water and electricity. They average $30 per night. Now let's rate everything that's important to us as campers from a 1 to a 5, 1 being not so great and 5 being as good as it can get. First, the booking process. Well, it's online. The pictures are what you're going to see when you get there. And you can cancel online or modify your reservation for a $10 fee. Overall, it gets a 5. All the sites have lots of privacy with vegetation in between each site usually. Most of the sites are rather large. They're clean when you get there. Most are going to be level. And it's pretty easy to back your rig or your RV in once you get there. The roads are paved and there's no overhanging trees. Yeah, this is as good as it gets. 5. Now let's talk about the amenities inside the park. Well, there's over 20 miles of hiking. There's mountain biking and regular biking on paved trails. There's water to get out on Lake Kissimmee. There's also a tourist attraction here called the Cow Camp, where you can learn about the Florida crackers. The only thing bad about this is the cell phone coverage is barely there. You'll get 1 to 2 bars on Verizon and maybe 2 bars on T-Mobile. Because of that, we rate this 4.6 for amenities. Another thing Lynn and I like to look at is what's nearby once we get there, because we don't usually just stay inside of the park. We like to look at things like Walmart and shopping centers and grocery stores. We also like to eat out, so how close are we going to be to restaurants and fun things to do? Maybe unique things, maybe some touristy things. Well, Lake Kissimmee State Park is out in the middle of nowhere, literally. About 14 to 20 miles away from each one of these things that we like to do once we get to a park. So because of that, we're rating each one of them a 2. So then overall, we would rate Lake Kissimmee State Park a 4.15. And how did we get there? Well, the booking process is as good as it gets. It gets a 5. The sites are as good as it can get, a 5. The amenities, if it had cell phone coverage, it would also get a 5, but it gets a 4.6. The only thing with the park that you're going to really want to know is it's not near to anything other than the park. So it gets a 2, bringing the score down to a 4.15. Now, what does that mean to Lynn and I? What it means is this is one of the best stops we've had in a very long time, and anything over a 4 means we would drive out of the way to stay there anytime we can. Hey, thanks for being part of our journey as we discover all of these state parks in the state of Florida, warm weather and wintertime. Lynn and I are very grateful that you're part of our journey. If you haven't subscribed, hey, take a moment and do that and follow along. And if you have any suggestions of parks that we can visit in the future, please let us know in the comments. And until we see you again, somewhere warm, happy tales.